As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
Alaykum
as-salam. Suratul Adiat. Adiat, it is the horses that go into jihad. Not every horse, but the jihad horses. That's what it called Al-Adiyat. The wow in the beginning is a swear, like we say, Wallahi. Lahi, that's the name of Allah, but the wow is the swear. If you say Wallahi, you swear by saying wow with the lahi. Same thing, if you say Billahi, the B is the swear by the word Lahi, name of Allah. So Lahi is the name Allah. When you add wa in the beginning, it becomes swear by saying Wallahi. Or you put B in the beginning, Billahi, the B make it swear. Otherwise, if you say Lahi, it's not swear, you just say the name of Allah. Same thing when you say in the beginning, Tallahi, you swear by mention the ta in the beginning. Without the ta, Lahi is the word Allah, name of Allah, is not swear word. But if you put a wa or b or the ta, that make it swear. Wallahi, billahi, tallahi. Those will be the swear. It's another swear word, is la. But that will not be added to name of Allah. Lallahi. It will not be. So, La uqusim. La uqusim. Allah say, I'm swearing. That la is a swear. But here, wal adiyati, Allah say, I swear by the horses, dabaha. Dabaha. You know, when the male horse is running, you can hear something noise, cock, 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 while it's jumping. That is dabaha. Some say this is coming from the throat, some say it's in their belly, some say it's in the testicle. Whatever it is, we don't know, but we heard the noise. That noise is dabaha. Allah swear by the horses, those who go into the jihad, when they're running, they make that noise. But muriyat, those same horses again, Allah swear by the horses, those who going faster. Muriyat is the running faster. Qadaha. And when they're running, qadaha mean the hooks kick the ground, you can see the sprinkling fire. Like if you press two stone, the fire sprinkle out. So that is qadaha. When they're running, the hooks hit the ground or the mountain or the rocks, you can see the fire sprinkle coming out of them. And last way by those horses, three different ways. To the four. First, babaha, wal adiyatu babaha, those who when they're running, they make that noise. Fal muriyati, the when they're running faster, qadaha, when they're running, their foot, their hooks hit the ground, you can see the sprinkle of the fire coming out. Fal muriyati subaha. Allah say again, the fire again is swear. This fire is a swear. فَالْمُورِيَاتِ قَدَهَا I swear by the horses that when they run, they run fast and their hooks kick the ground to get the sprinkle of fire. فَالْمُغِيرَاتِ صُبَهَا Those who are surrounded, I swear by the horses, those who are surrounded the kafir, non-believers, صُبَهَا in the morning. صُبَهَا mean in the morning. That's what they call Fajr prayer, Salatul Subh. The Salatul Fajr, that's the two optional prayer you're supposed to pray before the obligation. The two obligations called Salatul Subh. So Salatul Fajr is a sunnah. Salatul Subh is mandatory obligation. Fal Mughirat, those who surrounded around the kuffar, the non-Muslim, non-believers, Subh, early morning. Fa athar nabihi naqa'a. And when they come, when the horse come with the speed and stop the same spot, and it's a group of horse, what will happen there? It's going to be dusty all over. That's a qadaha, naqa'a. They spray the dust all over. You can't even see people. Allah swear by those horses. It's haram for him, for the slaves, to swear by anything other than Allah. It's okay for Allah to swear by anything he creates. It's showing the dignity of thing that he swear of. Importantness of the thing that he swear of. That means those horses are very important to Allah in order for him to swear by it. For وَسَتْنَا بِهِ جَمَعًا, and they will come together, groupily, under non-Muslims, non-believers. This is the swear. So now we're coming to Jawab al-Qasim. Why? Allah swear about all this. If I say, I swear by Allah, I swear by my Lord, I swear by the Lord of the creation, I swear the one that owned my souls, I swear by the one that provided for me, I swear by all this title of Allah, for what? Now I'm coming to tell you why I swear by all this. So Allah swear by all these five different things. Swearing, they say this is the answer of his swear. He swear and said, Innal insan. Like if I say, Wallahi, the human being a disaster. So Allah said, I swear by all this to say, Innal insana li rabbihi la kanud. Kanud, someone who's hard-headed. Innal insan, indeed, the human being, li rabbihi, into his Lord, la kanud, he's hard-headed. He don't listen to his Lord. It's not that many people who follow the rule of Allah. We always reject them. We bypass them, feeling like life cannot be like Sharia of Allah. That was back in the day, not anymore. That's what we said. Innal insan, indeed, the human being, insan mean human being, lakanud, lirabbihi, into his Lord, lakanud, he's hard-headed, he don't listen. He always rejected. He always said, but. If he say anything, they say, but because of this, because of our time, because of America, because of London, we are in the Europe. What is different? It's not but. That's lakanud. Wa innahu him, human being. That human being, wa innahu, that human being, ala dhalika la shahid. Himself is witness. The himself, the human being self, are witness of his hard-headed, that he reject his order from the Lord. Wa innahu, that human being again, lihubbil khayri la shahid. Love the money so much. Until you neglect Allah. This is true. That's our life. We love to be all in the money so much until we cannot even pray on time. Some of them don't even pray. Not on time. Some people, soon they get a visa, they fly to this country, they become Catholic, they don't pray anymore. They got two jobs, three jobs, whatever they can make. And the money never stay. وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ. حُبِّ means lover. He is a lover. لخير, the wealth. لشريد, very hard. His love into the wealth is very heavy than anything. So you love the money than anything in the life. أَفَلَا يَعْلَمْ. Don't that person know, that human being know? إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ. When the things come, what out? When the things come out of the grave, whoever die, everybody die, will come out of the grave day of resurrection. أَفَلَا يَعْلَمْ. The human being know, إِذَا بُعْثِرَ. When people are resurrected, or things that was in the grave was resurrected. قُبُور is the plural of قَبُر. قَبُر is one, قُبُور is more. أَفَلَا يَعْلَمْ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُور. Don't that human know that things will come out of the grave? To emphasize, whatever you do hidden, openly, it will be no more secret that day. It's all going to be coming out. In this life, you hide it and do it, nobody sees it. But that day, there will be no hiding on you. Everything come out. وَحُصِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. And everything was in the heart as an aiming. Desire that you love and you wishes They all come out of your heart. You only have one thing in your heart, how I'm going to be saved from hellfire. You don't think of mother or father, money, wife, kids, husband, no. وَحُسِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ, the heart become emptier. Don't have no touch in there, no feeling. But one thing, how I'm going to escape. إِنَّ رَبَّهُمْ بِهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَخَبِيرٌ. إِنَّ رَبَّهُمْ, indeed their Lord, their owner, Allah, their Lord, Lord of the Heaven, their Lord, be him with them. يَوْمَئِذٍ, that day, لَخَبِيرٌ, he is well known, he is aware of them, whatever they're doing. إِنَّ رَبَّهُمْ بِهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَخَبِيرٌ. Indeed, the Lord, their Lord, are with them, with knowing everything on them that day, he's aware of it. That is the tafsir of it.